y'all, it's Kate, and today I'm going to be talking about the books that I read in February. This month I read 6 books, which is a whole lot more than I expected I expected myself to read, so I'm very happy with that. The first book that I read is Sway by Amber McRee Turner. This book is about a girl named Cass who's 10 years old, and her mother is a rescue worker, so she's not home very much. And so one day, whenever they're welcoming her mom home, things take a turn for the worse, and in short, her and her dad set off on a road trip in an RV that they call The Roast. And her dad tries to make her life a little more interesting and to add some fun in it. Sorry, my mom just like cackled downstairs. Like, I didn't know she could cackle. I gave this book 3.5 stars, and if it sounds interesting to you, I would definitely recommend it. My only complaints about it were it's very predictable, I guess you could say, but it was also a very sweet story, and I thought it really did a great job of portraying the perspective of a 10-year-old girl so well, and I really respect it for that. The next book that I read is The Curious Incident of the Dog in the Nighttime by Mark Haddon. I absolutely love this cover. I don't know why. I mean, it's just the upside down poodle really appeals to me. And the orange is so bright that it's just nice. And I just really, really love how this book is just published, okay? It's just so great. And the font is so nice, and it's so nice to turn the pages. And it's so interesting. This book is very odd. So this book is about a boy named Christopher who has Asperger syndrome. And that is a form of autism in which it kind of creates trouble interacting in social situations, I guess you could say. And so this book, even though at first I thought this was going to be a book about the investigation of a murder of a dog, it is absolutely not that. It is so much more than that. This is just an insight into how the mind of someone with this condition works. And it is so fascinating, honestly. Some interesting things about this book were that all the numbers of the chapters are prime numbers. So they skip around, like it doesn't go to, it starts at 2, and then it goes to 3, and then 5, and then the whole book, it's just prime numbers. Like, it's so interesting. And then there's like diagrams and stuff, because that's how Christopher thinks, you know, he thinks like this, and math problems and stuff are included, and because he's a prodigy at math and stuff, that's very common for a lot of these people with this condition. They have, you know, special things that they're like really good at, and then they just love it. They're just so passionate about them. I really, really love this book. I gave it 5 stars, and the only complaint that I had about it was that at times it kind of, like, the same things happen again and again. But it makes sense because that's how he thinks, and he doesn't really branch out of his comfort zone. So I guess it's not really a complaint. It's kind of me acknowledging that fact. Like, that's the way that it is on purpose. So I don't know. I really, really love this book. So if this sounds good to you, definitely, definitely read it, please. Also, I think I have reviews up for both of those books that I just talked about, I think. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. The next book that I read this month is The Wicked Wicked Ladies in the Haunted House by Mary Chase. This is a very short book, so I read it very quickly, and kind of quickly. Like, with this length, you'd expect me to finish it in like one sitting, but I didn't. I actually spent like 2 days reading this, but I enjoyed it. It wasn't anything spectacular. I thought that Maureen was kind of, well, she's childish. She's actually like 10 years old, I think. I don't remember. I think she's like 10. And it's just, I don't know. It's a fun story because of the time travel element. Okay, anyway, this is a book about a girl named Maureen Swanson who lives near this old haunted mansion. Well, let's just assume that it's haunted. And she is just always intrigued by it. She hangs out by it, and then one day she manages to get in. And inside the mansion, she finds these 7 paintings of these women in the hallway, and they actually move, and when you touch them, it's not paint, it's silk. So, dun dun dun, I know, so mysterious. This was a decent book that I enjoyed reading, so I gave it 3 stars. The next book that I read this month is Secrets of the Cicada Summer by Andrea Beaty. This is also a short book, and the line spacing is very large, but it still took me a couple days to read because school. But this book is about a girl named Lily who lives in a very small town named Olina, I think it was. She's very young as well, I forget, probably around the same age. I read a lot of books with 10-year-olds in this month. And the whole thing is one day this girl, Tinny, comes to town, and Tinny kind of takes the place of Lily in a way. And Lily is a very interesting girl because she does not talk. Ever since the death of her brother Pete, she doesn't talk to anybody, and she just reads Nancy Drew books. And like, when I say she doesn't talk, she literally does not talk to anybody. And this is interesting to me because I actually had a friend who didn't talk either. She could, but she didn't. And she actually started talking when she went to high school. So I don't know, it kind of made me understand that, but in a different way. Like, she doesn't want people to know what she's thinking. And I don't know, maybe that's how one of my friends was, but I don't know. I wouldn't be able to know. It's such an interesting story. And at first, I was probably sitting around like giving it a 2 stars because it was nothing special at first, you know what I'm saying? But there was just this one point in the book where I started crying, and then I realized how attached I was to the story at that moment, and I don't know, I really enjoyed the outcome, and I thought it was a really cute story, so I gave it 4 stars. The next book that I read this month is To All the Boys I Loved Before by Jenny Han. I absolutely loved this book. Okay, I've heard so much about it, and like a book club that I'm in on Goodreads was reading it this month, so I picked it up, and I didn't expect it to be that good. Like, I know everyone talks about it like that, but I didn't think it would live up to my expectations, and it so did. So this book is about a girl named Lara Jean who has 2 sisters and a dad. Her mother passed away, and this book takes place in a time in her life where her older sister is going to college, and she's kind of having to figure out how to live without her and how to take the responsibility over her younger sister. I'm missing like the main point. I'm so good at this. So Lara Jean writes these love letters to her crushes from the past whenever she doesn't want to have feelings for them anymore, so she gets them out, but she never sends them. She keeps it in a box. But then one day all of her letters are sent out, and in this book she has to deal with the aftermath of that. Okay, I was kind of conflicted because at first I really didn't like Peter. I didn't like his attitude, and I didn't like the things that he said to Lara Jean. But he did grow on me, and I'm not sure if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I really do like Peter now, and I really, really want to read the second book. You know, P.S. I still love you, but whoever has it at the library and it's overdue for them is not returning it, and I've had my hold on it for like 2 weeks now, and they're really slacking because it was due a week ago for them. I'm a little bitter. So I gave this book 5 stars. My favorite book of the month by far. The next book I read this month is Notes from the Midnight Driver by Jordan Sonnenblick. This is also the last book I read this month. Should have said that instead. Great. So this book is about a 16-year-old boy named Alex who his parents are separated and his dad is dating his 3rd grade teacher. So one day he gets drunk and he tries to drive to his dad's house to get revenge, I guess, even though he doesn't have his license. And he ends up crashing into a lawn gnome on someone's yard. So he gets in trouble with the law, and he is assigned to this man at a nursing home named Solomon Lewis as his community service for his crime. In this book, Alex becomes friends with Solomon, or Saul as he's called in the book, and they form a friendship, and they learn from each other, and it's really, really great. And I love Saul because he is Jewish, so he uses like Yiddish vocabulary words, and it's so funny because Alex will have no clue what he's saying, and then he'll look it up later and it'll be just some crazy insult that's hilarious. And I don't know, I found this book to be hilarious. Jordan Sonnenblick's writing is just so witty, and it's really, really a joy to read. The only things I didn't like about this book, or thing I guess I should say, it's only like one thing, is the romance between the main character and the other character it was so cute, and I was just waiting, you know, there's that moment, like the big kiss, and it never happened. And it just, it felt like it was teased so many times, and then by the end of the book, it never happened. And in a way, I kind of appreciate it because it always happens, you know, in most books, like by the end, they've kissed and everything. But in this book, they didn't, and I was annoyed, but I also respect it. I'm conflicted. But anyway, I gave this book 4.5 stars, and I really, really loved it. And if it sounds good to you, definitely read it because it was so good. All right, so those are all the books that I read this month, and I'll be back in a little bit with my March TBR. Wow, March. Okay, that's come by real fast. Okay, so anyway, see you soon. Bye.